the brand new edition of To The Point. I'm Kriti Mishra. And on today's show, I have with me Health and Family Welfare Minister of India, Dr. Harshvardhan. Dr. Harshvardhan, welcome to Raj Sabha Television and thank you so much for joining us. Sir, India's response has been proactive, preemptive and graded against coronavirus. But where do we stand in terms of flattening the curve and also their concerns about registering dip in the number of cases?
Thank you for saying that we adopted a proactive and a preemptive strategy. And just to remind you and your viewers that India was the first country in the whole world to have responded to the news of a coronavirus outbreak in China on 7th of January, when they informed the WHO and the whole world. And on 8th January itself, in my health ministry, we had called the meeting of group of experts. In the next couple of days, on 17th of January, we had issued detailed health advisories to all the states. We had started point of entry surveillance at our airports, and later on we did that on our seaports also, as our land borders also. We started our community surveillance, and then you have seen over the last 3 months, we have been working very hard, round the clock, and relentlessly, all of us have been working to ensure that the curve about which you are talking, it never had a steep rise in our country. It never showed an exponential growth. And today, I can say with so much of pride and confidence that the curve is steady. And right now, our efforts are aimed at reversing the curve. You have seen that by now, over 13,000 patients have recovered well. They have gone back home. And majority of our patients who are admitted in the hospitals, they are on road to recovery. A large majority of them have either mild or moderate symptoms. Just about 0.22% patients are on ventilator today, and just about 1.22% are on oxygen, less than 2% are on ICU beds. And we have the least mortality in the whole world, that's about 3%. We have gradually started opening the economy. We have gradually started relaxing the norms of the lockdown. And the normalcy, you can see, is returning back gradually. And we are confident that in the next couple of weeks, we should be able to turn the tide and have a convincing win over the coronavirus, that's COVID-19.
So we understand that the mortality rate in COVID-19 patients in India is 3% as compared to 7% globally. Only 0.33% patients are on ventilators and 1.5% patients are on oxygen support and 2.34% patients are in ICU, which reflects the quality of care being provided across the country right now. But there is a major concern about the second wave of coronavirus or chances of cases getting relapsed.
In your question itself, you have acknowledged so well that our mortality rate in the whole world has been the least, and less than 3% of our patients are either on ventilator or on ICU beds or are needing oxygen support. And thousands of our patients have recovered well, they have gone back home. Regarding the virus, we all know that this virus was born only a few months back. China had reported about this virus to the whole world in January. And since then, the whole world has been fighting the pandemic of COVID-19 with all the possible resources available. As on today, nobody in the world knows whether the virus is going to come back again with a strong wave. There are no incidences of such occurrences anywhere in the world till now. As far as we are concerned, in our science laboratories in biotechnology and in CSIR, we are doing a genetic sequencing of almost 1500 viruses of corona, and we are trying to assess the mutations that it is undergoing, trying to assess the virulence or the change in virulence or its behavior. So it's too early to say how is it going to behave in the future, but we are trying to do our best to mitigate the sufferings of the people from COVID-19 at this moment.
Right, sir. You've also said at the WHO meet that the current situation on COVID-19 in the world is alarming and requires special measures to mitigate the number of casualties. Now, what are these measures that you envision?
As far as I remember, in recent times, I had the privilege to be part of a video conferencing hosted by WHO with all the health ministers of the whole world. And at one of these meetings, the World Health Organization had asked India to present the success story of India, and I had presented on behalf of India to the whole world health ministers how we were the first ones in the whole world and what did we do in the last 3 months. You know that our story has much more successes as compared to the rest of the world, and there at that meeting also I had emphasized and said that we have the least mortality, we have been doing a great amount of community surveillance, we have screened lakhs of passengers at all places, we have put over 1 million people under community surveillance. For every found patient, we had done extensive contact tracing, and our strategy had been to search as early as possible and do extensive testings, and for every positive patient, take them to the hospital as soon as possible and then give them the best possible treatment. That's the strategy on which we have worked, and starting from one lab, now we have almost 430 laboratories in the country. We are doing over 80,000 tests in a day, and our present capacity is 90,000 tests in a day, and we intend to go up to 1 lakh tests per day. So that's the strategy, and there is a strategy for containment, there is a strategy for locating the hot spots, and this is what I think the whole world is ensuring that they have the best strategy, they are putting their best foot forward, and they are trying to do their best according to the conditions in their own countries.
So moving on, how do you actually assess the effectiveness of the lockdown in containing the spread of COVID-19 in India? We had had 3 successive lockdowns.
I think under the leadership of our Prime Minister, we were very fortunate that we got this lockdown strategy as one of the major components of our fight against COVID-19. And if you recall, on 22nd March, the Prime Minister had that great innovative idea about the Janta curfew, in which he prepared the whole country for the impending lockdown. Now we have already had 2 lockdowns, lockdown 1, lockdown 2. We are into the lockdown 3 now, and there also we have opened up quite a bit. The country had shown a lot of good quality discipline in following the guiding principles of lockdown. And if I have to assess the success of the lockdown, then the parameters of our success against COVID-19 will, I think, demonstrate that quite well. Before lockdown, if you look at the doubling rate, it was around 3 days. And today when we talk about the doubling rate, it's something between 10, 11, 12, 13. That's the change that has happened. And during lockdown, most of the people have stayed at home. And I have said it on a number of occasions that till the time we are able to find a vaccine which is going to help individuals in their personal capacity only, the social distancing norm which has been propagated and publicized and advocated even by the Prime Minister in no uncertain terms, and added to this the lockdown that we all had over the last 40-45 days, I have said that this is probably the most potent social vaccine, and this has till now yielded great dividends for the country. And this is where it has brought us. We are in a phase when we are gradually opening up the economy. We can see that the country is slowly and steadily returning back to normal. So overall, I have no hesitation in saying that lockdown and the discipline of lockdown being followed by people has been hugely successful. While I talk about the relaxation in the lockdown principles, with the detailed guidelines being issued by the Home Ministry, I would once again reiterate and appeal to the people of India that don't relax too much. Please follow social distancing. Please follow the guidelines of the Ministry of Home Affairs very strictly. And I would also like to appeal to the authorities and the various state governments to enforce the principles of lockdown very, very sincerely, because this is something which is going to ultimately lead us to the final success.
Sir, India intends to do at least 1 lakh tests per day by 31st of May 2020. Given the size of India's population, how do you plan to scale up testing in a manner that it can be sustained?
I think the history of the last 3-4 months gives answers to your question quite well. It was only a couple of years back that we used to send our samples and swabs to America for doing the virology tests. And when we started our fight against COVID in January, we started with just one lab, that was the National Institute of Virology, Pune. And today when I talk to you, we have over 430 labs, about 325 or so in the government sector, and over 100 labs in the private sector. Yesterday itself, we did 80,000 tests in a day. When the ICMR reported to me that today their capacity of testing was 90,000 tests per day. You are talking of 1 lakh tests per day by 31st May. This is a statement which in fact I had given a few days back, because we wanted to achieve that target by 31st of May. But you can well appreciate that it may be earlier than 31st of May when we shall achieve this target. And I am sure the way we are improving our testing strategy, and where we have improved our testing abilities, and we have done a great ramping up of our testing facilities all over the country, we should be able to pick up every positive patient in the society as early as possible from all parts of the country. And that's what is reflected in every day a few thousand new patients also being reported through the labs.
How is the government ensuring that essential health services during the COVID-19 pandemic that are given to the patients?
You see, on one hand, we have prepared ourselves for the worst of situations. We have dedicated COVID hospitals, COVID health facilities, COVID care centers all over the country now. And if I have to count the number of beds, isolation beds and the COVID care beds and also the ICU beds in these facilities, I think the number may go to more than 4 lakhs. That's one part of it. But regarding the services for non-COVID patients, for our routine health programs, we have made it amply clear and we have been emphasizing time and again. I have been talking to the health ministers again and again. I have been calling meetings through video conference of all our AIIMS-like institutions, all our medical colleges, all our hospitals, and emphasizing again and again that non-COVID patients and the facilities and the services to them have to remain unhampered and undiluted. And we are in fact monitoring this particular aspect in a very, very, I would say, meticulous manner. We are even monitoring the vaccination, immunization services. We are monitoring the maternal and child health services. We are monitoring our tuberculosis elimination program. So, in spite of COVID there, which has brought a lot of activity for our health workers inside the hospital and in the field, we have made sure that non-COVID activities do not get compromised at any cost.
And what is the probability of finding a cure or vaccine for COVID-19 in the near future? Where do we stand?
You know that whether it is the pharmaceutical industry or whether it is the vaccine industry, India has been a global leader. In our fight against poliomyelitis, we were the biggest supplier of polio vaccine to the whole world. Similarly, to discover a vaccine against COVID-19, we are again leading the fight. We have at least half a dozen candidates for vaccine development. Our biotechnology department is supporting all of them in all possible ways. We have a forum where the drug controller and all the related agencies are hand-holding and ensuring that they facilitate the path for the discovery of the vaccine. And the good thing is that we are all blessed by our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji. Today evening itself, he held a very significant meeting of all the stakeholders with our scientists in the Department of Biotechnology. And I will not be surprised, because we are also actively pursuing this with the World Health Organization, where they are coordinating the efforts of the whole world. And I will not be surprised if India will be contributing to a breakthrough in vaccine development against COVID in the near future.
And finally, sir, your message to the country as you lead India's fight against COVID-19 pandemic.
Thank you, India, for the stellar role that you played during the last 3 months. You stood like a rock with our Prime Minister and with the Health Ministry. You showed exemplary qualities. You showed exemplary dedication. You showed exemplary commitment to follow the guidelines that were issued from time to time. You respected the guidelines of lockdown. And that's the reason why we have come so forward in our fight against COVID. Now is the time to start consolidating as the lockdown relaxes and the country starts coming back to normalcy. We all have to play a very crucial role. As long as there is lockdown in various areas, we have to continue to respect it. And then we all have to contribute to restoring economy, to take care of the unemployed, take care of the poor, and once again show to the world that India, a democracy with 1.35 billion people, can do difficult things we can make impossible things possible with our joint strength, with our commitment, with our sincerity, with our vision. And we have the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Please ensure that we get success in near future.
But Harshvardhan, there have been concerns over shortage of PPE and testing kits by state governments and the private healthcare sector. How do we boost domestic production of these important medical equipment?
I think this is an old question which has been solved and has become quite irrelevant today. Today the situation is such that there are many states in the country where when we send them the PPEs, they say they have no place to keep it, all their stores are full. And when we started our journey of the fight against COVID, definitely there was an issue about the PPEs because they were not manufactured in India. The linen for this used to be imported from China, and there was so much of trouble around China also. But this COVID-19 episode has turned out to be a blessing in disguise for India. We have been able to boost our Make in India movement. Today when I am talking to you, we have over 107 manufacturers and suppliers of PPE kits in India itself. And with the help of some 52 manufacturers, today itself, we had the delivery of over 2 lakh PPE kits and over 2 lakh N95 masks, which we distribute every day to various state governments and the various hospitals in the central government. So, PPE shortage or N95 mask shortage, this is no longer an issue at all.
All right, on that note, Dr. Harshvardhan, thank you so much that you joined us on this conversation with Rajya Sabha Television, gave us those important inputs and details at this hour of crisis. Thanks a lot for joining us, sir.